SpaceX founder Elon Musk is racing against time to develop the Starship spacecraft that could enable humans to become a multiplanet species. SpaceX is preparing the vehicle to perform the first orbital flight test, during which Booster 4 will propel the Starship SN20 spacecraft to orbit from South Texas and land in the ocean. In a recent interview with science communicator Tim Dodd, Everyday Astronaut on YouTube, SpaceX founder Elon Musk said they do not plan to recover Starship SN20 during the first orbital flight. For the first orbital launch, our goal is to make it to orbit without blowing up, Musk told Dodd, and frankly, if the booster does its job and something goes wrong with the ship, I will still count that as great progress, he said. To be totally frank, if it takes off without blowing off the stand, stage zero, which is much harder to replace than the booster, that will be a victory. So, please do not blow up on the stand, Musk added. He explained that, stage zero, is the launch pad support structures, which include the launch tower, mount, propellant tanks, flame diverter system, among many other things surrounding the launch pad. Musk said stage zero is much harder to build than a ship and booster. Before attempting the orbital flight, engineers will conduct a series of ground tests to ensure the launch system is ready. The stacking operation was part of a fit test. Starship SN20 was transported to the launch pad last Friday. Musk said that they will finish installing thermal protection system TPS heat tiles to SN20 at the assembly facility, located less than 5 miles down the road from the launch pad. He expects the ships to be ready to begin ground tests in approximately 2 weeks. They will finish preparing the sites, ground propellant storage tanks, as well as work on the quick disconnect tower arm for Starship, also add thermal protection to the booster engines. CEO Elon Musk says that SpaceX could return the first orbital-class Starship prototype, and its Super Heavy booster, to the launch site after rolling the rockets back to the factory for finishing steps. In response to a video of Super Heavy Booster 4B4 returning to the build site, Musk rather specifically stated that both Booster 4 and Starship 20 will return to the orbital launch pad on Monday, August 16. SpaceX returned Ship 20 to its high bay vertical integration facility mere hours after the Starship was stacked atop a Super Heavy Booster B4 for the first time ever on August 6. For unknown reasons, perhaps due to high winds, Booster 4 spent another 5 days at the pad, before SpaceX finally lifted it off the orbital launch mount, and rolled it back to the high bay, where it took Ship 20's place on August 11. Almost immediately after S-20's August 6 return, its 6 Raptor engines were removed to make way for an engine-less proof test campaign, that Musk has now implied could start as early as next Monday. Mirroring S-20, SpaceX also began uninstalling Super Heavy Booster FAS 29 Raptor engines, the same day it returned to the high bay. Around 12 hours after the process began, SpaceX appeared to have removed 14, just shy of half, of Super Heavy B-FAS Raptor engines. A pace almost as spectacular as their 12 to 18 hour installation a bit less than 2 weeks prior. Aside from making engine removal dramatically easier, Musk says that SpaceX moved Ship 20 and Booster 4 back to the build site to expedite some minor final integration work, namely, small plumbing and wiring. However, aside from Raptor removal, the most obvious and significant work, ongoing since the pair's return to the high bay, is the process of inspecting Starship S-20's heat shield, and repairing or replacing broken, chipped, and loose tiles. Not long after Ship 20 arrived back at the build site, workers in boom lifts began a seemingly arduous process of inspecting the Starship's nose cone, heat shield, and marking, with colored tape, hundreds of tiles with cracks, chips, or other less visible issues. After several days of inspections and hundreds of tiles marked, SpaceX finally began the process of removing off nominal tiles early on August 12. According to NASASpaceflight.com, that removal process is not particularly easy, and can require the use of power tools to effectively cut tiles off their embedded mounting frames. Given the amount of force required, some level of care is also almost certainly needed to avoid damaging any adjacent tiles, which could quickly cause a minor misstep to exponentially spread. Nevertheless, a small team of SpaceX technicians seemingly managed to remove no less than several dozen, and maybe 100-plus broken tiles in a few hours. Up next, those removed tiles will need to be replaced. Still, it remains to be seen if SpaceX will choose to fully complete Starship S-20's 98% done. Heat shield before sending the ship back to the launch site, for proof and static fire testing. To a degree, putting Starship through a gauntlet of ground tests, with a full heat shield installed would be an excellent test of the resilience of its thermal protection system to major thermal stresses, from frosty steel skin and expansion contraction during fueling, as well as violent vibrations during static fires. However, Starship S20's heat shield is already so close to completion, that it might be only marginally less valuable to save time, by testing the vehicle as soon as possible. To an extent, Booster 4 is a much simpler case as Super Heavy needs to major thermal protection. However, according to Musk, some or all of Super Heavy's 29 Raptor engines will need their own miniature thermal protection system. Perhaps a flexible blanket-like enclosure, not unlike what SpaceX uses to partially protect Falcon booster engines during re-entry. It remains to be seen if Booster 4 will return to the launch site without engines for cryogenic proof testing, or if SpaceX will install heat-shielded Raptors. Before starting the first flightworthy Super Heavy's first test campaign. For over a decade, Musk has invested his time and assets to develop technologically advanced rockets that are partially reusable and capable of safely launching astronauts to space. The aerospace company is already in the history books for returning human spaceflight capabilities to the United States in 2020. When a Falcon 9 launched NASA astronauts to the International Space Station aboard the Crew Dragon spacecraft. Though, Musk does not want to settle in low Earth orbit. His end goal is to create an exciting future, where humans can have the option of living on Mars if they choose to. Building a permanent city on the Red Planet can give our species a chance of survival, if a mass extinction-level event were to threaten all life on Earth. Musk has said on multiple occasions that Starship is key to preserve the light of consciousness. SpaceX works around the clock to develop its next-generation launch system. Starship will be fully reusable and capable of launching tons of cargo to the Martian surface. SpaceX is significantly speeding up the spacecraft's development progress this year, at its Starbase facility in Boca Chica, Texas. Teams are already preparing the first full-stack Super Heavy Starship duo that will perform an orbital flight test. Musk gave an exclusive tour of the Starbase facility to Tim Dodd, who is a space communicator best known as Everyday Astronaut on YouTube. During the interview, Musk talked about the importance of innovating rapidly. Quote opening square bracket ellipsis closing square bracket. If we operate with extreme urgency we have a chance of making life multi-planetary, Musk said, it's still just a chance, not for sure. If we don't act with extreme urgency, that chance is probably zero. Thanks for watching this video, and it's a super interesting topic. If you like this make sure to subscribe. If you have any crazy ideas about what we should cover in next video please comment it below, and we'll see if we can get to it. So thanks again for watching and goodbye.